Alma and How She Got Her Name is about the story of a little girl named Alma Sofia Esperanza Jose Pura Candela. She goes to her dad because she's concerned that her name is just too long and it doesn't fit. And this actually leads to a great time with her father where she learns about how she got her name and how each part of her name is connected to one of her ancestors. One thing I really like about this story is how it starts with Alma going to her dad about a concern that she has. And instead of her dad saying, okay, well, you have to accept it because that's the name I gave you, he invites her in to make that decision for herself by giving her the backstory. So for my deaf students, we practice a lot of introducing ourselves with our names spelled out, so finger spelled, and also with our sign names. In the deaf community, I, as a hearing person, can't just figure out my own name sign and say, I want this to be my name sign. Usually it is a member of the community, a deaf person, who gives me the sign name, and we agree on whether we think that fits. So my students and I were able to also share not only about the name stories, about the names that we were given at birth, but also about how we each got our different sign names. During a virtual learning setting, Alma would be a great book to do as a read aloud. You could use it as a virtual background through Zoom and have it kind of behind you. And I actually use that for my students. And I would move around on the page, and the kids actually were more engaged because they would try to find where I was on the page. So this book is also great for making connections, whether that's text-to-text connections and using other books where characters kind of wrestle with their names or learn about their names. It can also be used for text-to-self connections. How do I, as a reader, identify with the characters in the book? Are there certain things that we share? You can compare and contrast. It could also be used for Latinx Heritage Month. So the author actually has different words in Spanish written out through the book and in the illustrations. And so that would be a great way to learn about how words are presented in English, how they're presented in Spanish, and any other languages that may be in your classroom. Another great thing is that this book is available in Spanish, and so Spanish-speaking families can also get the book so that they could share it at home in their home language. Another way you could use it for Latinx Heritage Month is Alma, she learns about one of her ancestors named Candela and how she would always stand up for what's right. So that's another way you can connect it to other historic figures and current figures that we should really know about in the Latinx community. This book is great for learning about names and sharing about identity and culture. And I really think that everyone should have it in their home libraries, in their school libraries, take it to the park, just get a copy for everywhere.